Sige, tara na di.
Hi everyone, welcome back once again to another video. Hope you all are doing well and staying safe. Here lockdown is again extended till 9th of June. It's sometimes really frustrating to get locked at home, but thinking of the pandemic, precaution is always better than cure. My husband and kids were a bit frustrated hearing the extension of lockdown, so I thought I'll give a simple treat for breakfast, preparing their favorite and eat together at our garden. For dinner, a simple veg pulao and white chicken curry. Hope you would like it. Keep watching. It was a Sunday that I vlogged. My husband's favorite is French toast, which is a very common snack we have in the evenings, but he loves to have it all day. And for kids, I thought to give some extra to the French toast, which they love. For me, I prefer spicy over sweet, so prepared paneer paratha. So for the dough for the paratha, I used whole wheat flour, around 2 cups. Some salt. Then black pepper powder. Then to this I added few dried herbs, which is totally optional, but it adds taste. I added dried oregano, parsley and basil leaves. Add water and knead well. This is room temperature water. If the dough is sticky, add flour and knead. Use some oil and spread over so that it doesn't dry. Keep it covered and let it rest for some time. I had shown this one time, I guess, in an Eid vlog from Riyadh. This is how you can store coriander leaves and mint leaves for more time. Add some water in a glass jar and place the coriander or mint leaves, removing the ones that has got decayed. Place a plastic cover on top and store in the fridge. You will have to change the water every 2 or 3 days if possible. Now for the paneer stuffing, you will need coriander leaves, garlic and green chilies. Add that to a food processor or a blender. Add few paneer cubes. Add this to a bowl. To that add some salt, black pepper powder, cumin powder, some oil and mix well. Just make balls of the mix so that you get an idea of how many parathas you will get. Accordingly, you can also make the dough balls. If you like more stuffing, you can make bigger balls. I wanted a light flavor in it as I added more green chilies. So adding more stuffing will become more spicy and the parathas might break while rolling. Start stuffing the paneer ball as shown. You actually don't need to roll as it can be easily spread with your fingers. Just to give a shape, you can use a rolling pin. do all the same way. I love to use iron tawa for parathas as it tastes much better than nonstick. Spread some oil or ghee or butter, whichever you like. Adding a drop of ghee for extra taste, but you may skip if you don't like. Now the French toast is a very simple one that anyone could prepare as the ingredients will be easily available. Breaking in eggs. My husband loves it when it is extra sweet. Adding powdered sugar will be easily dissolved. Then goes in milk and some salt. Mix well. Now for flavor, you can add cardamom powder or cinnamon powder or even both. Heat a tawa. Now this is non-stick tawa and to save time, I use this large one to cook many at a time. Spread some ghee, dip each bread in the egg mixture and place on the heated tawa. This again would taste better on iron tawa. As time was a bit running, I had to speed up the cooking. Now for kids, making a mixture of cream cheese, Nutella and mixed fruit jam. Mix it well until creamy. Now spread the Nutella mix on a slice of bread. Then place another slice on top, just like a sandwich. Prepare all the same way. Now to dip the Nutella breads, use eggs and a pinch of salt. Since the spread is already sweet enough, not adding any more in the egg mixture. Just like preparing the French toast, apply some ghee, dip the Nutella sandwich in the egg mixture and place on the heated tawa. It was almost time for breakfast and everyone was getting hungry. Serving the rest of the spread in a small bowl. That's good to have along with paratha. To that, adding some black salt, or if you have chaat masala, you can add that instead. It was a bright day, a bit sunny, but wasn't hot that we couldn't sit for breakfast. And that was a lovely breakfast with chit-chats and heart-filling dishes. You can see the paratha stuffing is less, but it was really flavorful and spicy. that's the Nutella bread or the sandwich. Soft and really creamy. Kids were totally enjoying this. Do try this for your kids as well. I'm sure they would love it and want more. If you don't have cream cheese, you can add mozzarella cheese. And if you're a vegetarian, you can use a mix of corn flour, all-purpose flour or maida, and water along with some salt. This spread can also be applied on the French toast, but that would be a bit more sweet. You can also use some plain bread for this. I usually prepare chicken curry that's red or yellow in color. This time for a change, made white in color, yet very tasty and creamy without using cream. Crushed ginger and garlic. Heat a pot and add oil. You can use any oil or even ghee or butter. Add a bay leaf, cinnamon stick, cloves and cardamom. Then add the crushed ginger and garlic and let the raw smell leave. Meanwhile, blend one onion. Once the raw smell of the ginger and garlic is gone, add the onion paste and let it cook well. Now time to add the chicken pieces. Mix well. Let the chicken pieces turn to a pale color. Once the color changes, add coriander powder, black pepper powder, and a bit of garam masala powder if you want, but it's optional. Add salt, that's curd. Mix well. Add little water, not so much, as there would be enough water from the chicken and curd. Then cubed potato and mix well. Cover and let the chicken cook well. For the curry, you will need roti or rice to have it. Here, I'm preparing a veg pulao. It's really simple and tasty. I'm preparing it with just 2 cups of rice. So for that, you will need 1 onion, 1 carrot, and 1 capsicum, all chopped. You can chop to your preferred size. I chopped to tiny pieces so that kids don't be choosy to put those out from their plate. And you may use more vegetables like beans, cabbage, cauliflower, and such. This is cashews, soaked in filtered water so that I could blend it with the same water. Once the chicken is cooked well, add the cashew paste. Curry would go thick as it sits, so if you want to have more gravy, you can add enough warm water now. It would get thick later. Check the salt and add if needed. You can add a bit of sugar for a balance. I in fact forgot to add. Last, slit green chilies. Let it boil for a minute and it's ready. Switch off the flame. Moving on to the pulao, add oil or ghee into a pressure cooker. Add bay leaf, cinnamon, cardamom, and cloves. Then goes some whole black pepper. After a few seconds, add onion and saute till translucent. Then goes in Kashmiri red chili powder. This adds a beautiful color to the pulao. Make sure you don't burn it. Let the raw smell go. And now it's time to add carrot and capsicum. Mix well and it needn't cook so much. Then goes in drained basmati rice that had been soaking for around 15 to 20 minutes. Give a mix for a few seconds and then goes in hot water. Take double the amount of rice and here I've taken 4 cups. Add some salt and mix. Cover and lock the pressure. Make sure you keep on high flame. Once the steam comes or the first whistle comes, keep the flame to very low and cook for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, switch off the flame. Nowadays we have early dinner and that's the delicious veg pulao with white chicken curry. So that was a simple day vlog on a Sunday. Hope you all enjoyed watching it. I have been receiving lots of recipe pictures on my Instagram. Thank you so much for trying and sending me feedback. Do try the recipes of today's video as well and let me know if you loved it. See you with another video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.